In this video, we're going to take a look at dosage calculations based on ratio and proportion. Now, many nurses have difficulty with drug calculations, mostly because they don't enjoy math. However, many drugs do require some type of calculation prior to the administration, so it's important to practice careful and accurate calculations to help prevent medication errors. Now, in this example here, we're to calculate the amount to give in each of the following. So for part A, the order is decloxacillin, which is 125 milligrams, but the drug available is decloxacillin, 62.5 milligrams per 5 milliliters. Now in the second part B, the order is 520 milligrams of a medication in a 24-hour period. The drug is ordered every 6 hours, so how many milligrams will be given for each dose? Now, read the questions for part A and part B again very carefully. I want you to pause the video now and use your ratio and proportions to answer these questions. For part A, if we have 62.5 milligrams per 5 milliliters of decloxacillin available, and our order was of 125 milligrams, how much should we give? Well, 125 milligrams over how many milliliters? So I'm going to put the variable x under 125 milligrams, which is supposed to represent the milliliters that you're supposed to give. Now, if we just cross multiply and solve for x, what we would get is x times 62.5 milligrams, and on the right hand side, 125 milligrams times 5 milliliters. Now keep solving for x, divide everywhere by 62.5 milligrams, and 125 milligrams times 5 milliliters, all divided by 62.5 milligrams. Well, here the milligrams will each cancel each other out, and this would reduce to 625 milliliters divided by 62.5, which then reduces to 10 milliliters. So 10 milliliters is the amount to give for part A. Now for part B, if 520 milligrams of a medication in a 24-hour period is ordered, then how much would that be per hour? So 520 milligrams over 24-hour period would work out to approximately 21.67 milligrams per hour. Now that's per hour. So if the drug is to be ordered every 6 hours, how many milligrams would there then be for each dose? Well, all you would have to do then is take this 21.67 milligrams per hour and multiply that by the 6 hours. The hours here will cancel each other out, and what you end up with is 130 milligrams. Now, how many times would you be giving 130 milligrams in the 24-hour period? Well, if there's 24 hours in total and you're giving it every 6 hours, that would reduce to 4 doses in the 24-hour period of 130 milligrams.